Hello and welcome. You're watching The Big Story. I'm Afrida Rehman Ali. Today, our focus is on the new law announced by the Center to Tackle Pollution and also the formation of a new high-powered commission with 20 permanent members, which will look at the issue of air quality management in the National Capital Region. Yes, this is a law that has been passed through the ordinance route in order to tackle pollution in the Delhi NCR region. The law comes into effect immediately. Under the new law, a powerful permanent commission of over 20 members will be formed for air quality management. The penalty imposed by the panel for violators go up to 1 crore rupees as fine and also 5 years of a jail term, depending up to 5 years of jail term, depending on the level of violation. The commission will have the authority to prohibit activities causing pollution and take action against erring department heads. The members of the panel will be from both center and from the state. So that's the larger issue that we are looking at. What we have right now is another commission which has come up with a new law to curb pollution in the National Capital Region. This is supposed to be a deterrent for those who have indulged in activities that have aggravated the situation of pollution in the National Capital. In fact, I am now joined by Mr. Anand Arya, who is an environmentalist, joining us here on Mirror Now. Good afternoon, Mr. Arya. Thanks for joining us and giving us your time. I do understand that you've been extremely active in the issue of environment in the National Capital Region, and you've been extremely active in protecting wetlands in particular. I want to ask you, you know, at a time like this, when we are looking at a very critical juncture, first because of the COVID, which is again a respiratory related ailment and difficulties, and on top of that, this is precisely the time of the year where the situation gets extremely aggravated with Diwali around the corner, the issue of firecrackers also active. The government has decided to come up with a new law. This is supposed to be a deterrent. Now, my question to you is, we of course already have a number of commissions and boards. In terms of monitoring agencies and in terms of policy makers, there's no dearth per se. In your experience, do you feel that this is what we needed at this time? What is your expectation out of this high-powered commission that the government has formed?
I think point number one, it looks like old wine or a new wine in an old bottle or an old wine in a new bottle. I don't think that this is going to make any difference at all. You see, the key to the problems that we have at which we have been shouting at the top of our voice for the last 7-8 years had been the implementation of the decisions and the directions issued by, and in the law as such, they exist. Then on top of it, the National Green Tribunal on hundreds of occasions, it has issued directions. The Supreme Court has issued directions. There is an EPCA, which is now defunct under the new law. And that has laid down exactly the sources of pollution, what is to be done, when it is to be done, how it is to be done. So to my mind, the only thing which had been missing from the whole lot of the last 7-8 years that I have been very, very active on this issue, it had been the implementation part of it. And whenever,
yes,
even NGT, for example, when it was fining, I remember Delhi government has been fined 50 crores at one point of time, 25 crores at one point of time. The only difference which I'm seeing in the new or in this ordinance versus the previous this thing is that the now probably the departmental heads will be held accountable, and probably these will be the people who will be in a way who would be sort of penalized. Now this is what we have been shouting from the housetop, that why penalize the government? Like Delhi government, if you are put in, I think there is another imposition of fine by NGT on Delhi government of about 30 odd crores. Now, this is my money. It is taxpayers' money. It is our money.
Yes.
Why should I be paying this? Instead of holding a particular person responsible, and I've been shouting from the housetop that I really don't understand why the Supreme Court has the powers to ensure that whatever direction it issues, they have the powers to see that it is implemented by any means. Now, why is Kejriwal not being penalized? Why is the Chief Secretary of Delhi not being penalized? Now, see, I can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 10. You tell me okay. The number and I will count the actions which the Delhi government has not done. Like today, at the peak, they say about 20-25% is the pollution because of parali. What about the remaining 75%? Who is going to do it? And this 75% is not only for Delhi. It is relevant for Haryana. It is relevant for Punjab. It's relevant for Uttar Pradesh. So what we lack is the implementation and of the action plan that we know. So unless and if commission, I don't know how it will implement all these things, because ultimately, as I see, the only appeal I can take it is the NGT. And then who cares for NGT today? Nobody cares. Nobody cares for NGT. Tell me, has the Yamuna been cleaned?
Right. So those are real issues that you're highlighting, Mr. Arya, and I agree with you to a certain extent that at one level, an overarching authority is necessary to penalize the department heads, because a lot of times there is a lack of coordination between the multiple departments. Also, let's not forget this government has not been very clear on its environment policy. On one hand, it has made environmental clearances pretty easy for in the name of ease of business, etc. And on the other hand, of course, at times like this, it has taken this option of forming another high-powered commission. I will just come back to you, sir. The other issue that we are looking at right now in the national capital is that even as the NCR recorded a daily caseload of over 5,000 yesterday, Delhi's air quality has now dropped to a severe category, which is why this issue is pretty alarming at the moment. If we look at the PM levels, the pollution levels, the particulate matter levels in Delhi, it's alarming. It's dropped to the severe category. And taking cognizance of the spike in the pollution levels ahead of Diwali, the Delhi government has called for green crackers to be used in the national capital during the festival. Now, the appeal comes in as Delhi government is all set to launch an anti-firecracker campaign on the 3rd of November. So this is, again, another contentious issue that, just a few days to go for Diwali, these decisions are taken, but will it be something that can be implemented in time? Manufacturers say that it will be difficult to manufacture green crackers this time around for Diwali, since production was mostly shut due to the lockdown. The Supreme Court had banned the use of conventional firecrackers since 2018 and had allowed only green crackers. So, Mr. Anand Arya, see, this is where we get stuck with issues, where on one hand, a policy on paper is in place. But again, like you also said, how will this be implemented? Look at the timeline that we have now before Diwali. Just to shoot off an order saying only green crackers allowed, will that help? Because these crackers are not accessible to the consumer.
You see, I very frankly, I have been trying to find out what is a green cracker for 2 years now. And I don't think that there is anything known as a firecracker, a green firecracker. You may say laser shows, etc., and the noise you make through using laser beams, etc. I mean, that could be, environment friendly. But any cracker you use, you will use paper, you will use some combustible material, you will use some chemicals for colors. So I think what Supreme Court should have done, and we have been, I would use the expression shouting from the housetop, that why have a cracker at all? What is this green cracker concept? Why have them? If you have to have them, have the designated place and just 1 hour.
Yes.
In Delhi, you have to have it, have it on top of the India Gate or just somewhere outside. And just for half an hour, 45 minutes, so people can just gather there and see if they want to watch. I mean, what is this, permitting a green cracker under the OU? The moment you open the great gate, anything will pass through green cracker. I just have to put in a sticker on it that this is green. Who is going to check? Who has checked ever? So I think the and Diwali for me, from the times immemorial that we have been hearing, how is it to be celebrated, how it got invented, and how we started celebrating Diwali, was essentially using the, earthenware. I mean, yeah, aapke deep use karte se. You were using diyas, you know, and that hardly caused any kind of a pollution at all. Now, the as far as the firecrackers, as we know them today,
yes.
I mean, they got it only when we, I think about 300 or 400 years ago that we found the explosives, you know. So before that, I mean, what is this? You know, if we want to celebrate Diwali, I mean, is the cracker the only way? I really don't understand. You can put in a diya, you can put in a mombatti, that hardly cause any pollution at all. And that is the way the Diwali is to be celebrated. Nowhere, you know, in the origin of Diwali did we ever have any crackers coming.
Right, absolutely, Mr. Arya. And which is why we keep saying that while the government may have a huge role, the citizens must also pitch in with their part of the responsibility. Whether it is COVID or whether it is restricting pollution, the citizens, the residents of Delhi will also have to exercise certain amount of caution in the kind of steps they take. Like Mr. Arya said, why don't we go back to how the original way of celebrating Diwali used to be before this entire concept of firecrackers came into the picture? Thanks very much, Mr. Anand Arya, for joining us and giving us your time. Thank you.